Hello students, today I am here with another topic of your syllabus, and this time the topic is from writing section and the topic is speech writing. You have already done this topic in class 11th and it is there in class 12th too. So let's discuss speech writing, as how to write a beautiful speech. First, it is about the learning objectives. What the student will learn? They will learn to express ideas in clear and grammatically acceptable English. They will learn how to plan, how to organize and present ideas coherently in the speech, and how to present their ideas in the form of an argument, and how to use an appropriate style and format. These will be the learning objectives for you all. Monitoring, checking and revising the written work will be followed by the earlier points. Okay, let's move to the next. Types of speeches. What are the types of speeches? The very first is informative. Second is persuasive. Third is special occasion. So the kinds of speeches I am going to discuss. First is informative. It is informative, speaking generally, centers on talking about people, events, processes, places or things. Okay. In which the speeches in which we are providing the information, or we are speaking generally about the people or some event or some process or some place or things, that kind of speech would be called as informative speech. Then persuasive. Persuasive speaking is the type of speaking that most people engage in the most. This type of speech can involve everything from arguing about politics to talking about what to eat for dinner. Means here in this speech you will have to express your views in the way as if you have to persuade someone, as if you have to convince someone. Okay, a type of speaking that most people engage in the most. Most of the time people are engaged in such kind of speeches. They try to convince the people. Okay, and the topics may be anything from arguing from politics to talking about what to eat for dinner. Then about the special occasion. Special occasion for ceremonial, commemorative or apodictic. It's a kind of speech that should pay tribute or praise a person, praise an institution or an event or an idea or a place. This would be the third kind of speech which is presented on a special occasion. Okay, let's move next. Next is about the components of great speech. What are the components of great speech? The first is style, that is the text that are beautiful to hear and to read. Means the style is one of the components of the great speech. The style in which your text is presented, it should be beautiful. It should be beautiful to hear and beautiful to read. Second component is substance. Substance should have a worthy theme that appeals and inspires fine values and ideals in the audience. So the substance, it should have worthy theme, proper theme that could appeal, that could inspire the values and ideals among the audience. Then third component is impact. The best speeches change the hearts and minds. Means its impact should be such as it could change the hearts and minds. It should appeal to the hearts and minds of the people. So these are three components. Next is some unforgettable speeches. Here some think about the unforgettable speeches of some famous people of the world. They lifted hearts in dark times and gave hope and despair refined impact. These speeches, when they were presented, when they were delivered, they had lifted the heart in the tough times, in the dark times, and they had given a hope and enthusiasm in the desperate times. They were having very refined impact over the people. So these speeches are of Socrates, these are of Mahatma Gandhi at the time of Quit India movement, and Rabindranath Tagore about the crisis of civilizations, Swami Vivekananda when he had addressed at the World Parliament of Religions, then of Jawaharlal Nehru, Tryst with Destiny. Tryst is the mean, its meaning is mutual agreement. Martin Luther King, I Have a Dream, his speeches given there. And APJ Abdul Kalam, My Vision for India. So these are certain unforgettable speeches about these famous personalities. Now let's discuss the format of a speech. In order to write a perfect speech, we must be well acquainted with the topic and must possess a wide range of vocabulary, a thorough knowledge of the subject, some research and excellent organizational skills. If you are going to write a perfect speech, then these are the things one should possess. That is, wide range of vocabulary you should have, good words, wide range of vocabulary, and you should have thorough knowledge of the topic you are going to write about. You should have material about it, and you, as well as you should have the skills to, organizational skills to write the speech. Here is the ideal format and tips to help you write your perfect speech. A perfect speech must consist of, the very first thing is heading. The heading should be catchy. Actually, at the top, heading, if you have written, then it's okay. If you haven't written, then also it's okay, because it is introduced in the address. Okay, so the heading, whatever you will be writing, it should be catchy and not more than 5 to 6 words. You can go as creative as you want with this one. Just make sure you do not devote too much time on it in the exam. Okay, while writing the heading, don't waste a lot of time. Just think, it should be creative, it should be catchy, and should not be more than 5 to 6 words. Opening line. This includes salutations, introduction, and the topic. Make sure you do not mention your personal details, and this is the most of the time, this is the mistake students mostly commit. Okay, don't provide your personal details like name, school name, etc. Okay, and example of opening line is, you may write in this way. You may make the beginning of writing your speech like, respected principal, teachers, and my dear friends, sign of exclamation. Today, I, if you want to write your name inside the brackets, but the name would be the same as has been given in the question. Today I stand before you all to speak on the topic, and the topic you will announce given in the question. Okay, or you could start with a quote related to the topic and then go with the salutations and introduction. So this is the opening line where you can introduce your heading if you are not writing it at the top. Then next, second thing is body. And body is the main part of your writing piece. Its content carries 5 marks. You must know this. Begin with a short introduction on the topic. It's meant to be precise. Then you need to explain the current situation, the problems if any, and whether after or after any corrective actions, betterment in the situation has been observed or not. So you have been asked to begin with the short introduction of the topic. It should be precisely presented, and you need to present the current situation in the beginning, okay, or about the problems, whatever have been given in the question, okay, and whether any corrective measures or actions have been taken for the betterment of the situation. this is to be present in the beginning. Then it may include advantages and disadvantages depending upon the topic in the question. Okay, if you have been asked to include advantages or disadvantages, you can include them too. Then follow a sequence. This is important thing. You should follow a sequence. Okay, first it was about the heading, opening line, then the body. Okay, and in the body, how you present? First you have to write about the problem, then you have to talk about its advantages or disadvantages, any measures have been taken or not, and then at the last conclusion in the form of your solution. Okay, follow a sequence. It is possible that you have too many points or very few points. Probably you might be having many points, you may be having few points. When you have a lot of varied points, it is better you choose a few best ones and write a line on each. In case you have a very few already, then explain them in at least two lines each. This is the best way. Okay, strictly follow the prescribed word limit in a limited time frame. So just do not go on writing and writing. Don't waste your time in writing and writing. Your marks may be deducted if you will be writing more than required. Okay, most important thing here, always begin with your strongest point. You can accommodate the weaker ones in between and end with another strong point. And feel free to give your personal opinion in one or two lines. Okay, this was about the body. Now about the solution or concluding paragraph, where you have to provide the suggestions. Okay, suggestions about the problem, you have to conclude, you have to give the solution. Now it is to be remembered that whenever you elaborate a problem, you always have to mention the steps being taken to improvise the situation and suggest a few solutions as well. So means you have to, most of the students we have seen in the answer scripts, that they don't write the conclusion part, they don't write the solutions or give the measures to curb that problem. So it is suggested that they should give a few solutions to add to in the last paragraph. Now it would be great if you could add a few quotes relating to motivating the people to take action. Here also the rule of strong, weak, strong applies. Okay, strong, weak, strong. Last but not the least, the concluding line, thanking the audience for their cooperation and their patience. It is very important to conclude what you have started. So at the end, to conclude, you have to thank the audience for their cooperation and their patience, because whatever we begin, it should be concluded. It is compulsory. Then, okay, and here, before going further, at the end, you have to write thank you also. Okay, last line, not the least, the concluding line, thanking the audience. Okay, thank you, to write thank you is must. Now let's take an example. Here is a question. You have to write your views. We will solve this question. You will understand how to write a speech. You are Ali Alia, head girl, head boy of your school. You are deeply disturbed by the rising cases of aggressive behavior of students in your school. You decide to speak during the morning assembly about it. Write a speech in indiscipline in schools in 150 to 200 words. The question is of 10 marks. Here is the marking scheme. You should understand what is the marking scheme, which part of the speech is going to fetch how many marks. So the format, that is the opening address and closing, means good morning so and so, and announcing the topic, as well as the thank you closing, thank you line at the end, it carries 1 mark. Okay, your announcing the topic heading carries 1 mark, and the content carries, main body carries 5 marks, and the expression carries 4 marks, and these marks have been bifurcated in 2 and 2. First 2 for grammatical accuracy, appropriate words and spelling, and second, two more marks for coherence and relevance of ideas and style. If you are presenting all your ideas in a coherent way and the relevance to the topic asked, then you will get 2 marks, means total 10, 1 plus 5 plus 4. Okay, this is the marking scheme. Now let's move. Suggested value points for the question. It was about indiscipline in the schools. So, about indiscipline. In the beginning, you will talk about indiscipline. Here are certain hints given, like rising cases of aggressive behavior of students, then kinds. Rising cases of aggressive behavior in students. Kinds, that is of, means aggression. Kinds of aggression like bullying, disobedience, fights, insults, truancy. You know what is truancy? Truancy is work shirking, not to do work. And violence. Then damaging school property may be one of the reason of this indiscipline. Then emotional trauma for the victims. Trauma is distress, psychological wounds. Okay, distress. So emotional trauma for the victim. So these are certain things about the indiscipline you have to write in the beginning. Then after, you will talk about the causes. What may be the possible causes for indiscipline among students, like role of parents, peers and social media. They may be held responsible for the indiscipline among students. Lack of teaching may be the cause. Inculcating moral value mean lack of inculcation of moral values, or not following role models may be the cause of indiscipline. Then last point, last part of the speech is solutions. So you may give the solution like counseling by teachers, family values, moral science and values discussed in the schools. Means family values may be the solution, counseling by teachers may be the solution, moral science and values discussed in the school may be the solution. Help each other's students to take initiative. Students, they may help each other to understand the ill effects of indiscipline, and then reference to positive aspects of social life. So for this question, the material, the content has been divided into 3 parts. First, you have to talk about the indiscipline, then about the causes, then about the solution. Now, let's see how the speech would look like. Here is the example of the speech. So, respected principal, teachers and all my dear brothers and sisters studying in this school, I am Alia and I would like to talk to you on the topic indiscipline in school. This is the opening, and now starts the main body of the speech. A few years from now, you just might wake up one morning to discover that your high school class is running the country. Present class. A class who is pitching against each other in groups, a class who does not abide by rules, a class filled with aggressive behavior. I want to dream of our school students running the country, not ruining it. In this way, you may make the beginning. Friends, I am sure that you are familiar with the innumerable cases of aggressive behavior of students of our school. There are many incidents of bullying among the students. They engage themselves in fights and squabbles. Squabbles are fights. Leading to acts of violence. Recently, some students of the senior secondary section had broken the basins in the washrooms. Is damaging of school property the solution to your anger towards the school authorities? Is this the way to resolve your problems with people who are actually your guardians outside your home? Here the speaker is raising a question. Okay, it is unimaginable how the victims of violence and aggression suffer from emotional trauma. Such emotional trauma can indeed injure their personality and hamper their growth as a person. Now about the causes, second part. There are many possible causes behind such aggressive behavior. Parents have a big role to play here. Adolescent behavior is also influenced by their peers. The social media feeds the youth with liberal doses of violence. Even the video games they play are full of attacks, counterattacks, and other violent behavior leading to violence. The more violent one can be, the more points you score. One of the winning ingredients for a hit movie is violence and bloodshed. You know this. Fight scenes in a movie attract the youth like flies to sweets. Why is moral science not made compulsory in every school? The curriculum of school education is sadly lacking in teaching or inculcating of moral values. Very few of us here have a role model whom we follow. And here are the solutions. Okay, solutions. You can see solutions. There are some possible solutions to the problem. Teachers need to give counseling to students. Means this is the conclusion part of the speech. Possible solution to the problem. Teachers need to give counseling to the students. At home, they should be taught to appreciate family values, moral science, and values need to be discussed in the school. Students can also take the initiative and help each other. I feel that we should indulge in some sports or other things. One sports, some sports or the other. This can give a healthy outlet to the feelings of anger or repression buried in our hearts and minds. Friends, it is indeed alarming that school news has come in the headlines for shocking incidents of bullying and even death. Surely we cannot allow the school to be a site of crime and violence. It is time we revise our attitude. We revise our attitude and discard the germs of negative attitude towards our friends and teachers. My dear pillars of the nation, let us start building a nation resting on the foundations of discipline and integrity. Thank you. So in this way, your speech gets completed. I hope you might have understood how to write it and what are the parts or the what is the format of a speech. Now, home assignment. Okay, note down home assignment. On the question, here are two questions, right? You have to write the speeches on. One question I have already discussed with you in the form of example, and here are four more questions. Please note them down, and you have to write down the speech on each of them. Total will be five speeches to be written in your notebooks. You will do this homework well in time, and I hope you would have noted it down. At the last, I would like to be thankful to you all. You might have understood everything. Please stay safe and healthy. Stay at home. Follow the instructions of your parents, elders, and government. Stay healthy. Keep taking exercises. Okay? Good luck. Best wishes. It was your teacher, Narendra Kumar, Pivot English, Kendriya Vidyalaya. If you find any problem, you may make a call. Okay? Good luck. Good day.